Hi everyone, welcome y'all. So in the today's video, we're going to see how we can work with the hooks in Cypress. And this is the one of the very useful feature in Cypress. Now we'll see how we can work with the hooks. So normally when you write your test, so we will include multiple it blocks, right? Every it block is representing one test, right? So for example, I have three different type of it blocks. Let's say one is for searching and another is for advanced searching, the other is for listing products. Let us assume I have three different features I want to test in your application. One is search, other one is advanced search, the other one is listing products. Okay, and these are the actual tests which we are going to execute and test. So before executing all the tests, suppose I want to execute some more statements. Let's say I want to launch my application, I want to launch my browser, or I want to launch my application URL. So that is a prerequisite. So before executing all these tests, whatever prerequisite which we have, we can write one method. Okay. And that we want to execute only once before executing all the tests. And that you can specify as a hook. There are four different type of hooks are available. One is before, after, before each, and after each. There are four types of hooks are available. Okay, let me write here. So the first hook is before, and the second one is after, and then we have one more thing called before each, and then we also have before after each. After each. So these are the four types of hooks will be provided by Cypress. This is after each. Okay, these are the four types of hooks are provided by Cypress: before, after, before each, and after each. Now the before, this is the one hook which will execute before starting all the tests in your describe block. That means before starting all it blocks, this before hook will be executed only once. And similarly, after hook will execute only once after completion of all it blocks in your describe. Before each, this particular hook will be executed multiple times before each and every it block. Suppose you have a three it blocks here. So before each hook will execute three times before every it block. So for example, let's say I want to execute search functionality. For that, first of all, we need to log into the application, right? And after completion of search functionality, again, I want to log out from application. So if you want to log in, I can create before each hook. And after completion of this it block, again, if you want to come out, then I can write after each, in which I can mention logout functionality. So before each hook will execute multiple times before starting every it block. After each hook will execute multiple times after completion of every hook. So before will execute only once before starting all it blocks. After each, after will execute only once after completion of all it blocks. And before each will execute only, before each will execute multiple times before starting every it block. And after each hook will execute multiple times after completion of every it block. So before and after, these two hooks will be executed only once. Before each, after each hooks will be executed multiple times, depends on the number of it blocks which we have in your test. Okay, now let us see the example. So here I have written one it blocks, three it blocks I have written. It's a, this is my search functionality. I'm writing simple log message. I say cy.log. And here I say this is login. Sorry, this is search functionality. I can say searching. And then this is the one statement I created. And now let us also write some statements in the advanced search. Let's say here I can say this is my advanced searching. And here we are listing the products. Listing products. Let us assume there are three different features which we want to test. So one is search, advanced search, and listing products. So now I have a three different tests or three different it blocks we have. Okay, now before executing all it blocks, what is the first prerequisite is we need to launch your application, right? Only once I want executor, and that is a common in every it blog. So before executing this search, first of all, I need to launch my browser. So I can write one hook here. That is before. How we can write it? Simply can say before. And inside the before, we need to write one arrow function. So bracket, this is my arrow function. So here we need to write our body. So what you want to do before starting all the it blocks. So I want to launch my application. So here you can simply write some piece of code to launch our application. So for now, I'm just writing cy.log. And here, this is for only for launching application. I can say launch app. So this will launch your application. So this particular block before will execute only once before starting all it blocks. Now, after completion of all it blocks, then I want to close my application. So for that, I can write one more hook called after. And this particular hook will execute only once after completion of all the it blocks. Now you can write anywhere. So order is not important. So here I'm writing after. Right, in the after, I'm writing the arrow function, one more arrow function. And inside this arrow function, we need to implement. Sorry, this is a bracket. Let me write once again. So now you can see after and a bracket. So inside this, we need to write arrow function like this. So inside this, normally we will write closing the application. I can say cy.log. And here I'm writing some log called close app. Close app. So now before method will execute, before block will execute only once before starting all it blocks. And after will execute only once after completion of all it blocks. Okay. So now what is before each and after each? So before each hook will execute multiple times before starting every it block. Suppose I want to do the search functionality. So I want to do the login first. And after completion of that, immediately I want to log out. Similarly, if I want to do advanced search, I want to first log into application. Then after completion of this, again, I want to log out. Same thing for listing products. To do this, first I want to log into application. Then once it is completed, then I want to come out from application or I want to log out from application. So those steps I can write for another hook called before each. Let me write one more hook here, before each. And again, we need to write one arrow function inside this. And these hooks are basically derived from Mocha framework. Okay, this is coming from Mocha framework and used in the Cypress. Okay, now before each, so this particular hook will execute multiple times before starting every it block. So here I'm writing one log, let's say cy.log. And let's say this is a login. Sorry, this syntax error. Okay, so here I'm saying just say login. Login is mandatory required to test another feature. So this particular hook is executed multiple times before starting every hook. And similarly, we have another hook called after each. After each. So this particular hook will execute multiple times after completion of every it block. Now here we need to write one arrow function inside this. So here I say cy.log and simply you can say log out from application. Like this, we can write a multiple hooks before, after, before each, after each. So how it is going to execute? So if I look at the order of execution, so the first thing, there are three test methods we have, or we have three it blocks. So let's say 1, 2, and 3 it blocks are there. So before and after will execute only once. So before execute here, after will execute here, after completion of all the it blocks. And before each will execute 3 times, because before starting here, before each will execute. After completion, after each will execute. Again, before starting second it block, before each will execute. After completion, after each will execute. Again, before starting third it block, again, before each will execute. After completion, after each will execute. But before and after will execute only once before starting all it blocks, after completion of all it blocks. This is how we can use hooks concept. Let me run the test and see in which order they are going to execute. So clear everything. Now let me save this script and let me open the terminal, launch my Cypress app, npx cypress open. Now my app is open, selecting Chrome browser. And here we have all the scripts. Now let me run my spec file, Cypress file. And here we have hooks and tags. Let me run this. So now it is successfully executed three it blocks. But what about other hooks? So if I just click on the search, observe here, I'm clicking on every hook here. One second. So which is executed, just click on these hooks one by one and you will see the log messages. Let me rerun once again. Okay, just a second. Let me save the file. All right, so now you can just search is executed, advanced search is executed, listing products are executed. Now if you observe this, so here you can see here, this is the launch app. So this is before, before all, before each. And you can see here, first launching app is executed. And then login is executed. And then search is got executed. And you can see login and logout is executed before and after the search block. It is a it block actually, this is a test body, before each, after each. And this is a before actually. So before all, that is executed only once. Okay, so if you look at this hierarchy also, if you look at the order of execution, this is executed only once. This is before hook, this is after hook. This is also executed only once after completion of all the it blocks. Now, actual, what are the actual tests here? This is a test searching, advanced searching, and the listing product. These are the actual tests. Now you can see before each, after each is executed, before and after every it block. So you can see the output here, launching app and closing app, login and logout, login and logout, and login and logout. So here searching test, advanced search, listing products, and then logout and then close. So this is the way we can execute. So what is the main usage of hooks is, if you want to specify any prerequisites before starting any test, then you can specify that. So instead of writing those steps in every method, for example, here the launching app is there, we will execute only once. And the closing app, we will execute only once. And suppose before each and after each. So instead of writing these two statements in every it block, we can just separate them into hooks. So whichever the statements are which are repeating for every it block, we can keep them inside the after these particular blocks, like before, after, or before each and after each. So these are all called hooks. We call them as a hooks in Cypress. So this is the terminology. Okay, so now we have something called tags. So what is a tag? So we have here three it blocks. We have three it blocks here. So by default, when you execute this test or describe block, by default, all three it blocks will be executed. Suppose I want to execute specific it block or I want to skip some it block. And that I can do by adding tags. For example, let's say advanced search. So I just want to skip this one. I don't want to execute this advanced search. But the rest of the two it blocks I want to execute. So simply we can say dot skip. This is one tag. So for it block, we can just add it dot skip. So this particular it block will be skipped at the runtime. So it will not be executed. Okay, now I can just save and execute and see. And I'm reloading. Now you can just see here, only search is got executed. Advanced search is not executed and listing products is executed. So we can also skip this method just by adding skip tag for that particular it block. Okay, suppose I want to execute specific it block. Rest of them I don't want. So currently we have a three it blocks. I just want to execute only listing products and the rest of the two I don't want to execute. So in this case, we can simply say it dot only. this is a one more tag which we have. So when you say dot only, only this particular it block will be executed and the rest of them will be ignored. Now let us save and execute now. So this is my Cypress app. Now I'm saving it. Now you can just observe here. I'm gonna rerun once again. Okay, now you can just observe. One second. Let me save the file again. File. Okay, so let me just rerun once again. The file is not got saved. It is not still not saved. Let me close and then save it. Okay, so now let me run one more time, go to the file and save. So if I now look at here, my Cypress app, if I rerun the test, only the listing products are executed. Only listing products, it block is executed. Rest of them are not executed. And not even skipped, first of all. They are not at all executed. Skipping is different. Ignoring is different. So here we are just ignored those method. We just ignored the other it blocks. So if you want to execute only one specific it block, you can simply say it dot only. So this particular will execute only this particular it block. Or suppose if you want to skip any particular it block, then you can specify it dot skip. So this particular thing will skip this particular it block, specific it block, it will be skipped. Okay, so this is a simple concept in Cypress. Hooks and tags. So hooks will be used to specify some prerequisite scripts before executing the actual it blocks. And there are four types of hooks: before, after, before each, and after each. And also we have different tags. Mainly we use skip and only tag. So skip tag will skip that particular it block in the runtime. And only method will execute only this particular it block and rest of them will be ignored, right? So this is all about hooks and tags. In the next video, we will talk about some other concept. Thanks for watching.